With iOS 18, Apple Reminders and Notes have gotten incredibly powerful. I've actually moved my entire video production workflow from Notion to Apple Reminders, and I'm going to show you how I've supercharged it using Bare Notes and some new features in Apple Notes that I haven't covered yet that I found incredibly useful. And if you stay till the end, I'm going to share a few shortcuts that streamline this entire process. Now, I've been using Notion for a long time for both my podcast and video production, and it works pretty well. I like some of the organization, but managing it on an iPad can be a little cumbersome, especially if you want to move around data and bullet points. Plus, as you know, I'm pretty into shortcuts, and while Notion does have a few shortcuts actions available, when you compare that to something like Apple Notes, where you have all these different options, including appending to note, getting information from notes, and tagging, and also looking at Apple Reminders with new actions available in iOS 18, I've moved everything over to the native apps. So this was my previous Notion board managing all my projects, and now here's Reminders. As you can see, I still get that Kanban style, but I can also do things like add photos, I'm linking notes over to Bear, I've added tags and other information, which also allows me to create smart lists here in Reminders, which I'll show you in a second. By the way, I should mention, to get this Kanban style view, click the three dots when you're on a Reminders list, and you can go from View as List, which is the default view, to View as Columns. Then you can also customize your toolbar up here by going to Customize Toolbar, drag whatever tools you'd like up here, and then you can actually tap the New Column tool if you want to just quickly create one easily. By the way, one of the cool tricks in iOS, which is selecting multiple items quickly with two fingers, also works in this Kanban style. So I can swipe down with two fingers and select multiple notes in a row. I can even do it on a second column, and now I've selected multiple notes across the columns here in Reminders. And if you didn't know, that also works in things like Mail. Swipe with two fingers and select multiple items. Yes, it also works in shortcuts here. It works here in Apple Notes and in a lot of places around your iPad and iPhone. Now I'm going to collapse the sidebar for a moment, and you can see I have my four columns here, and it's easy to move columns around just by tapping and holding on the column title, and then you can move it to the left or right. When you want to create a new reminder under a column, you can just tap in the empty field, and when you're done adding, just hit done. If you wanted to add a new column and name it something different, you can tap in the blank space on the right side, type something like new column, and then you can also title that column at the top. If you ever want to delete a column, just tap the three dots next to the column title and then tap delete. Any reminders under that column title will also be deleted. Now, the one shortcoming that Reminders has when compared to Notion is the amount of text and information you can put in a single note. If I tap the eye icon, it opens the reminder. You can title it, you can have a URL, which we're going to get to in a moment, but in this notes field, you're very limited. It's basically a single line text box. You can put a bunch of text here, but it's not conducive to having bullet points and information, things I use when I record a video. So what I've done is I've actually linked a bare note to every reminder here in the board. And now whenever I want to see information on that, I can just tap on this icon here and it sends me to the bare note associated with that video. Now, one of the shortcuts I'm going to show you in a moment is one that actually creates the bare note and reminder at the same time and links them automatically. So for every reminder I have here in my Kanban board, I have a link to the bare note, and then I could put things like due dates and times and also tags. Plus you can do things like set priorities, subtasks, and more. You can also change the column for every reminder here. Now, when it comes to tags, one of the helpful things I've done here is added tags per reminders if it's a short and if there's a sponsor for that video. Then what you can do is when you open the sidebar here on the left, you can create smart lists and then filter by all those tags. So these are just my videos that are shorts, and here's my videos with sponsorships. If I want to create a new tag, I'll just go into those reminder settings, go to tags. I can select some of the tags that I've already created, or add a new tag and hit enter. You can also view all your tags at the very bottom of your reminders list. And here you'll see all tags kind of in a tags cloud, and you can see all your reminders tagged as shorts or work across your different lists. So this gives you all the reminders tagged with shorts, and then the smart list I've created here, which I'll show you in a moment, lets you view the tags from a specific list that you'd like. I'm going to show you how to create those smart lists in a moment, but first, since we're talking about productivity, I want to tell you about SaneBox. I've been using SaneBox for several months, and it has helped me get to inbox zero every day and at the end of every week, getting all my spam and junk email into folders so I don't have to see it, and prioritizing those important messages so I never miss one. It works with all the major email providers, and I've connected it to my iCloud account, Fastmail, Google accounts, and more. One of my favorite features of SaneBox is I can actually snooze mails here in the stock Mail app on iPad and iPhone, which is unlike the Remind Me feature. The Remind Me feature in Mail still leaves the email in your inbox. Well, now I can filter an email and then move it to one of these SaneBox folders like Sane Tomorrow or Sane Next Month, It will go to that folder and disappear from my inbox until tomorrow, next week, or next month. And if there's ever a sender that I just never want to see an email from again, I can send it to the same black hole, and that sender will be gone forever. There are also zero hidden fees, premium customer 24/7 support, and they take information security seriously. They never share or sell your information to anyone. So go to my link today, try.sanebox.com/beardfm, and you actually get a $25 credit to any of their plans, monthly or annual plans that you choose today. So try Sanebox today at try.sanebox.com/beardfm. That link is also in the video description, and you get a $25 credit when you sign up for any of their plans. My thanks to Sanebox for sponsoring this video. Now let me show you how to create one of those smart lists and how I'm linking Bear Notes to each reminder. So you see, I basically have a folder here in Reminders, and I have my videos and other lists under that heading. Well, if I want to add a smart list, I can tap Add List, and here you start creating a new Reminders list. But under List Type, you can actually switch it from Standard to Smart List. Now let's say I want to actually have my Shorts filtered in this list. I'll name it Shorts. You can choose a custom color, choose an icon, and then here under Filters is where you have lots of powerful options. I can choose reminders that match all of these filters or any of the filters, and you see tags is here right at the top. I can choose any tag, any selected tags, so I'll choose my Shorts tag here, and you can even filter by date due, time, location, flag priority, and lists, and this is where I create those smart lists just for my videos. So here I can choose just pull reminders with that tag, and then I'll tap lists only from my videos list. I'll hit done again, and now I have a smart list that pulls just my reminders with that tag from that list. Now, if you ever want to delete a list, you can just swipe on it and click the trash can. And there are some limitations to the smart list, which I'll get into in a moment. So you see here, I have a list for my shorts and sponsorships, and let's go back to the Kanban view. Now, as you can see, I have Bear Notes linked to each of these videos. For instance, I can tap here and it'll go to the Bear Note. And this is actually the note I'm referring to on my Mac while I'm recording this video. Now, if you've followed the channel for a while, you know I've talked about Bear multiple times, and it is my preferred note app. Apple Notes has come a long way, and I'm going to show you some special features that aren't in Bear Notes in a second. But one of the things I like about Bear Notes is I can tap and hold on a note, and copy link to note is so easy to get to. I can copy that link, go over to my reminders, and then I paste that link here in the URL field. Then I can quickly access that Bear Note just by tapping the symbol connected to that reminder. When it comes to Apple Notes, you can get a link per note, but it's a little more cumbersome. You can't tap and hold and just get link. Instead, you have to share the note, and then when sharing it, you have to make sure it's accessible via link, and even copy sometimes will just copy the text of the note rather than the link. So when it comes to just getting the link to a note easily, I like Bear. Plus, it supports Markdown, has a ton of features. I've talked about Bear in a past video. I'll link one of those videos above. And finally, one of the other features I love here as a Reminders Kanban board are these nice photos I can attach to certain tasks. Helps me quickly see what video is which reminder. And because of shortcuts, this has become way faster than using Notion. For instance, I'll show you the shortcut I use now to create a new video project. I call this my new video template shortcut. When I go into this shortcut, I ask for input immediately, which is the video title and which will become the Bear Note title and reminders title. Then I ask for more input, like if there's any information, brainstorming, bullet points that I want to attach in the note. From there, I create a new Bear Note with the title that I specified. Once that note is created in Bear, I actually come back to shortcuts. You'll see Bear actually has that option here, return to shortcuts. You do need to enable that. It's enabled by default. And then I actually get the note identifier. So I have a Get Bear Note action here, and then in this text field, I've actually selected the Bear Note, and you'll see File Path is what I have to choose here. This actually gets me the callback URL that will actually work across platforms, Mac, iPad, and iPhone. I split that text because it adds a .txt at the end, which I don't need. I get the first item, which is the note identifier, and then this creates a new reminder with the title that I specified at the beginning of the shortcut to my Videos Reminders group. You'll have to change that when you download this shortcut, and no alert there. Then if you expand this menu, under the URL section, this is the Bear callback URL that's default for every note, and then I've chosen the note identifier and put that at the end. You can download this shortcut in the video description below, and all you have to do is change what list you'd like the reminder saved to, and you'll need to download Bear as well. Oh, and I forgot to mention I also specify the tag, which is BeardFM Videos, every time this is created. I'm actually going to run this shortcut on my iPhone, and you can see it works cross-platform. I'll title it Best Shortcuts Ever. It'll ask me if there's any points or additional information I want to add. It'll create the Bear Note, send me back to Shortcuts. I'm going to choose Always Allow. Should only have to do that once. And the shortcut is done running. Now let's see how quickly this synced. Let me go to my bare notes here on my iPad, and you'll see a new note has been created called Best Shortcuts Ever. And if I go to my Reminders Kanban board, you'll see the Best Shortcuts Ever task has been created, and if I tap this link, it brings me directly back to that bare note, all of it created with just a single shortcut. Then I can move this into my In Progress column, and that other column automatically disappears once I remove the reminder out of it. Now, I wish I could specify an actual column in the shortcut. This way it goes directly to my In Progress or Shorts columns, but maybe that's a feature that will come in future Reminders updates. Also, two other wants in Reminders and maybe iOS 19 is in these smart lists. I would love to be able to create another filter for completed reminders. I can complete a video here in my board, and it'll go into the completed section, but I would love to see just my completed videos, and there's no marked as completed filter for smart lists. That is one thing I did in my Notion board. Whenever I would complete a video, I put it here, and after a few days or weeks, I would move it into my yearly completed videos. There's not a great way to do that in the reminders just yet, so hopefully that'll be added in the future. And one other feature that Apple could add to reminders and would obfuscate the need to even link different bare notes is to have that notes section for a reminder more robust. If this notes field could expand and do rich text, bullet points, and other links, I could do everything here in reminders and not even have to link out to another app, maybe in a future reminders update. All right, that's a look at how I'm using reminders for my video project management. Let me know if you have questions down in the comments, but I want to show you what I'm doing with Apple Notes now and some new features that I recently discovered. All right, first up, I'm going to open the Apple Notes app. We're going to talk about podcast bookmarks in a second, but I'm going to go to my Books Notes here. And one of the shortcuts I showed you in the past was actually scanning OCR text from a photo of a page and then adding it to a note. Well, Notes actually has a built-in feature that makes this way easier. Keep in mind, I'm running the iOS 18.1 beta, which should be out to everyone later this month. So now when I'm reading a book, and I do prefer physical books, this is one of my favorites, by the way, Elements of Eloquence, highly recommend. When I'm on a certain page and I want to save that text, I can actually tap the paperclip icon here in Notes. And while you can scan a document and actually scan the entire page, I've actually been using the Scan Text feature. Once you've opened the Scan Text feature on your phone, you can actually point it at any text, like in a book, and it will just automatically OCR it and add it to the note. I actually didn't tap anything. If I wanted to, I can tap this symbol down in the bottom right, and it'll show me the text it's copying. Then you can actually select text here in this view, and it will add just that text to the note. Tap away, and it will add all the text that you're scanning. If I hit the X, it won't choose to add it. I'll do it again, paperclip, scan text, and let's say I just want this kind of paragraph here at the bottom. It takes a second for it to recognize it. And as you move your phone around, you'll actually see it highlights different text as it's kind of searching the book page. And if I tap insert here, now I've added that text to the note, kind of a built-in bookmark symbol, and way less taps, and you don't even have to run a shortcut if you don't want to. Scanning text, really cool in Apple Notes. And one other use case you might find useful is if you listen to a lot of podcasts and you want to be able to bookmark a certain part of a show and even a link to the timestamp, Apple Podcasts actually has this ability. And I've created a shortcut to make it even easier, which I'll show you in a second. When you go to Apple Podcasts and you're listening to an episode of something like Primary Technology, that's my tech show with Jason Aten, you should totally subscribe, links above. When you're listening to the show here, you can go to the transcript view by clicking this icon, and then you can actually tap and hold and select a paragraph of text. Or you can even tap the Select Text feature and change how much text you have selected. Drag those little bars, and now you can copy that text and paste it in a note, but you can also share a link that will go to this timestamp in the podcast episode. So I can tap that link, and I can share this to a note or maybe on social media, but I've created a shortcut that expedites this entire process. You might want to create a shortcut per podcast you listen to just to make it even faster, but what this does is it will actually get my clipboard, which is the text that I copied, and then when I do the share URL from timestamp, this shortcut will show up in the share sheet. What this does is it actually formats the text a little bit, so I have the text that I selected, plus the link to that episode, and it'll even show you the episode title, and then appends it to a specific note of my choice. So I have a note here called Primary Tech Bookmarks. It has the text here, and even shows the episode title, the date, and a link to that timestamp. So if I select that, it will jump to that timestamp in the show. You can even see the little play button actually says from what time it will play. Really cool. Now, if you want to do that with the shortcut, I can tap and hold on a piece of text. I'm going to choose Select Text here in the transcript. And then what I'm going to do is copy the text here, then tap it again, and then hit the Share from Timestamp option. And now I can go down to my shortcut name, Primary Tech Bookmarks. I just tap that and it will automatically append to the note the text I had selected and the timestamp link. Look, there it is. There's the text I had selected, the episode title, the date, and a link to that timestamp. Now you can have an ongoing note, and you can also choose prepend if you want the latest text and link to be at the top. And now you can have an Apple note with all the text and links to your favorite podcast and your favorite moments. Now recently, some third-party apps have supported transcripts like Pocket Casts. So this could work in Pocket Casts as well. Let's say you're listening to a show like Primary Tech. Let's go a little ways in the episode, and you'll see this message bubble down here is actually the transcript here in Pocket Casts. Now you can select text here in the transcript and click copy, but there's actually no way to share it from this timestamp in this transcript view. You can hit the share button, but that's just going to share the plain text. Now Pocket Casts does let you share a certain timestamp by hitting the share button down here in the bottom left, and you can do current position, but it's a couple more taps than actually using the Apple Podcast version where you can share the timestamp from the transcript. You can make a shortcut that works with Pocket Casts as well, just takes a couple more taps. But those are some new ways I'm using Apple Notes and Reminders with iOS 18. If you have any questions on this setup, leave comments below this video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button before you go, which I recently crossed 100,000 subscribers here on the channel. So thank you to everyone who's been watching, subscribing. Very exciting. I should have my little plaque coming in soon and gonna do a whole video on that. So like I said, if you're not yet, get subscribed. And if you're interested in some of the other productivity methods I've been using in iOS 18, check out this video right up here. And if you want to learn about some of the Apple Intelligence features coming very soon to everyone, I'll be doing more videos on that once it's publicly launched. You can check out this video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.